and relate to every single people's life. And no matter what you are doing, are you following God or not, you always need it. Well, that is how to be wise, how to solve the conflicts in our life. So there was two examples through this small topic. And first of all, the trial one. Well, how to be wise like Paul, use the Bible well. In Acts chapter 23, verse 4 to 5, those who were standing near Paul said, "How dare you insult God's high priest?" And Paul replied, "Learned brothers, I did not realize that he was the high priest. But it is written, 'Do not speak evil about the ruler of your people.'" So here, you can see Paul was very successfully figuring out this trial he's facing. So people are accusing him that, "Oh, you cannot insult our high priest." And people point out Paul's fault, what he did. Well, he went to reflect his knowledge about the Bible, and he committed that he confessed that he was committing that part he was doing wrong. Now that's something really, lots of people doesn't really do nowadays. For me, also, I'm going to sort out this conflict. I always think about, how I'm feeling about this conflict. I feel this is not right. But actually, Paul's here is really right, because he relates to the Bible. He always believes that the Bible says is the truth. And how can it solve out a conflict? Well, the Bible, if the Bible is the truth of the life, it can be solve every single thing. And we don't need to really claim to relate to our opinion. Let the Bible speak. Trial number two. So let the truth to speak. So Acts chapter 23, verse 6 to 7. Then Paul, knowing that some of them are Sadducees, and others Pharisees, called out in Sanhedrin, "My brothers, I'm a Pharisee, descendant of Pharisees. I stand on trial because of the hope of the resurrection of the dead." When he said this, a dispute broke out between the Pharisees and the Sadducees, and assembly was divided. So you see here, it's quite amazing when Paul says something between these people who were trying to accuse him, these people suddenly just divided. So what's the power to speak the truth? Well, the Bible describes the truth as a double-edged sword, and how you kind of use this double-edged sword well is really essential. But a lot of time we just, in our life as a Christian, well, we just let our opinion to speak, just like the last one. Well, here, Paul is really wise because he let the truth to speak. So in conclusion, everyone wants to be alive with wisdom, do everything under the wisdom from God. However, it requires the fear of the Lord according to Proverbs. The challenge for today, well, is for every single people, okay, here, to know your Bible well, and to really sort out all these questions through the Bible and obey the Bible, and also to use that well, to use that correctly, and let the truth speak in your life.